guys, thank you for joining me today on another video. Today I'm going to be reviewing the Power Beats 3 with Beats X to see what's what, which one is better, and just give you a few details that I haven't seen anybody really talk about. And these are all from my own personal experiences. I've used both the Beats X and the Power Beats for a pretty decent time, and the Power Beats 3 I've used for a little less time, probably a week and a half, but the Beats X I've used for over a month, and I feel like I'm in a good position to tell you guys which one I feel is better and continue giving you a little bit of my own personal thoughts on each. And I'll tell you which one I favor a little bit more personally. So I used to be wary of the idea of wireless headphones and earphones because I've had a few in the past, but none of them ever convinced me to ditch my trusty old earphones. There were too many pairing haggles that came with Bluetooth earphones and headphones, and this made me think that Bluetooth earphones are really time consuming and they're not really worth it in the end. So whenever I just needed headphones, I would always stick to earphones that were wired so I could easily use them and not have to worry about charging them. So a couple of months ago, Apple announced the W1 chip. This chip was supposed to make pairing really easy. So this basically solved one of the biggest issues I had with wireless earphones and headphones. And not to mention that, you know, recently Apple stopped putting headphone jacks on their phones. And this made me kind of go mad in some points because I'd want to listen to music, but I'd want to charge my phone as well. And I couldn't do both, and I'd always have to carry around an adapter. This finally made me decide that I'm going to give wireless earphones another shot. So my first thought was buy the EarPods because they're the hottest new thing. And, you know, it would be much cooler to have those independently actual truly wireless earphones. But obviously the EarPods are completely out of stock everywhere. They're back ordered for weeks and they started shipping in December. It's July 2017 and they still don't have stock in stores, and you have to order them and they usually ship out in 4 to 6 weeks. So I wasn't really willing to wait for that much time. So I decided to go for the next best thing, which were, in my opinion, the Beats X. They came out alongside the AirPods, and what I decided was that they shared the W1 chip, and I believe that I would be more happy with the wired ones anyways because I wouldn't be scared of losing them. So I decided to, you know what, just go ahead and try it out. After a few days with the Beats X, I was madly in love with them. The Beats X are amazing. They have good sound quality. They have the amount of bass that I like. So just after a few days, I was in love with these and I was completely sold on the idea of wireless earphones. I then spotted these Power Beats 3 and it sparked a debate in my mind, which one would be better. And I decided, you know, I should get these as well and try them out and see which one I like more. So to start off, I'm going to run down all the specs of the Beats X and then the Power Beats 3. So I'm just going to give you a rundown of the specs of both of these Beats really quick so you guys can see what's what with each of these. The Power Beats 3 has an Apple W1 chip, a micro USB charger, has a battery life of 12 hours on a full charge, it is sweat and water resistant, has a charging time of a 5-minute fast charge that gives you 1 hour of playback, and 2-hour charge that gives you a full charge with 12 hours of playback. The cable length is approximately 18 inches. The Beats X has an Apple W1 chip, a lightning charger, battery life of 8 hours on a full charge, and charging times are for 1 hour of playback, a 5-minute fast charge, and for the full 8 hours of playback, 45 minutes. And the cable length is approximately 34 inches. Since we're done looking at the specs, I just want to let you know that specs don't really tell the full story here. And it starts off with the price. Beats X retail at $149.95, and these Power Beats retail at $199.95. So there's a $50 gap there, and when I bought the Beats X, there were absolutely no promotions, there was no sale, there was no price drops, and I ended up paying full price for these, and I even checked on Amazon, and I checked everywhere before I bought them, and $150 was what they were going for. Whereas the Power Beats 3, I bought for just $130, and this, I was completely stoked. I was like, oh my god, I got the best deal in the world. But then I get home, look at Amazon, and I see that they're actually $130 on Amazon as well, which surprised me because they sell for $200 on the Beats website. After spending some time with the Power Beats 3, I think I've come to understand why the price is what it is right now, and I'm just going to give you a quick rundown of why I believe so. So the Power Beats 3, these ones, were the first wireless earphones that Beats ever made. So not headphones, the over-the-ear style, I'm talking earphones that go into your ear, that go in. And when these launched, within Beats, these were the only wireless earphones, so they decided to price it a little bit more premium. It was at $200. And they had no competition from within. However, after Apple bought Beats out in 2016, Apple started making a lot of changes in Beats, and they started using a lot of technology from Beats, and they rolled out the new W1 chip in 2016. This chip was supposed to make the overall pairing process and the connection process a lot more easier for all these wireless earphones and headphones that Apple and Beats both were going to make. And with the introduction of this chip, Apple rolled out two new earphones, these Beats X and the AirPods that you've definitely seen somewhere. They priced the AirPods at $160, which was $159 or something like that on their website, and these Beats X were for $149.95. It was $10 cheaper, so technically it had the same technology that the AirPods had, but it was just wired. It wasn't completely wireless like the AirPods. After the introduction of the W1 chip, Beats updated the Power Beats as well, and they added the W1 chip and renamed it as Power Beats 3. Now the situation was that Apple and Beats had three earphones that were all wireless, all had the W1 chip, but they were all at different price points, and the oldest one was priced the highest. So what was happening was that the oldest ones, I believe that they stopped seeing a lot of interest. So by introducing two new earphones that were newer and better and cheaper, Apple and Beats basically cannibalized the sales of the Power Beats 3 within themselves. My assumption at this point is that now they've decided that it's crazy and nobody's really gonna buy these at $199. So they've decided to give a huge price cut to them, and they go for $129.95 in retailers, Best Buy, Amazon, and a bunch of other retailers. But the website still has $199.95 as their core price. So my assumption here is that Apple is trying to boost the sales and try to get rid of some of the older Power Beats 3 that they have. So maybe they can focus on the newer ones or come out with new Power Beats. I don't know. Now this price cut made me really curious. Does Apple think that the Beats X are better than the Power Beats 3? Or are the Power Beats 3 just a really good deal to get right now? So I was really curious and I decided to compare both of these, and I was kind of surprised by the results. So I'm gonna tell you what it was like and what I learned from using the Power Beats 3 for a week. I learned a lot of good things about it, but I learned that there were a lot of bad things about it as well. And I definitely wouldn't have gotten to know this unless I had used these earphones for a longer term. And I'm glad I did, because I found out a few things. So the first key thing is that the cable on these are a little too short. So they're about a foot long. And because they're only a foot long, for people like me who are a little bit, have a thicker neck, what happens is you don't get a comfortable fit when you put them into your ears. Because once they're in your ears and you look towards one side, the wire kind of begins to pull on the other side, which becomes annoying really quick. The fitting is a little bit uncomfortable as well, because the outer part of the earphones have this huge bulge, which really hurts the inside of my ears when they're fit really well inside. And the point of these earphones are to be all the way in your ear. And when they're all the way in my ear, they hurt a lot. So it's poor design choice, and I'm not sure if this only happens to me. Another issue I faced with these Power Beats were that the remote is in a really awkward position. So I'm always used to having the remote by my chest so I can just like easily get to it. But now with the remote on the back, it's weird to reach for your neck to adjust the controls, and it gets really annoying really quick, especially when you're at a gym or somewhere where you know you can't flexibly move your arms around when you're on an exercise machine or something like that. Another issue I learned was that it takes a lot of time to get these on the right way, so just watch me as I try to get these on. That should not take as much time as it just did. Earphones are meant to be quick, pop in, pop out, like the Beats X are, which I can just quickly pop in like this. Boom, I'm done. That's all it should take. I'm very surprised that these, despite being designed in a very useful way, the Beats X really, really aren't user-friendly enough. Especially when you're in situations where you only have like one hand free or something. It's very annoying to get the fit right. One thing I did enjoy about the Power Beats were that They look a lot nicer than the Beats X do. They have a really cool design, and you know, I love the huge Beats logo. Yeah, people know that you're wearing Beats, and it's a little bit of a fashion statement more than an actual design choice, and I kind of enjoy that. One last thing about these are, there is no way to secure them together when you're not using them, or it's just something that just, it kind of hangs there. Whereas the Beats X, you have this helpful little magnet that helps you connect the two ends, and they stay connected like this, and you can easily get them apart or put them back. So it's really easy to secure the Beats X because they have a little magnet on both ear tips, which makes it easier to store them away, or just, you know, when you're not listening to them, make sure that they don't fly out or fly away. This makes it really easy to make sure that they're securely around your neck, especially when you're doing some high intensity activity or something and you're not using your earphones, because they become into sort of a necklace that doesn't break off easily. Whereas the Beats X, in this case, it would just fly off if even some slight force were to hit it. So I definitely like the locking, that secure feature on the Beats X. So I gave you the thoughts on my experience while using the Power Beats 3. I'm gonna go into the Beats X. The Beats X are extremely comfortable and I really do love them. And I love this sort of design that they've gone with. Even though it's not it's not really good looking, it looks weird. And a lot of people would just confuse them for real wire headphones. But the immensely long wire really makes the wireless part of these earphones a bit redundant, but I've learned to love the design, especially because how secure it is. I can completely hide this earphone securely under my t-shirt and completely blend in. If I don't want it to look like I'm wearing anything, there you go. I can easily hide these, and they're not very intrusive. And they're not very easy to spot either, so they really blend in. So my ears are very irritable, and the really light earphone tips really help me enjoy my music for a long term, whereas the Power Beats, they make me a little bit annoyed. They become irritating around my ears, and personally, I think the Beats X were way more enjoyable to use just because they were comfortable. Another really convenient feature about the Beats X are that they have the lightning chargers. So I can charge these up anywhere I have an iPhone charger, so whenever I'm in the car or anywhere, and I can just charge them up really easily with one cable. I mean, I know that micro USB used to be the standard, but nowadays I see a lot more people having lightning cables than they do micro USB cables, and it's really comfortable to, you know, have one thing for my phone, earphones, and everything. Now I'm going to move into the pros and cons of both the Power Beats and the Beats X. And a lot of these pros and cons are after using them for a week. They're not based on specs. They're just based on my own personal experience. So I'm going to start off with the pros of each. So Beats X, the W1 chip makes pairing easier. That goes for both. The longer cable allowed me for more flexibility. So I was able to, you know, just have one earphone in and not worry about the other. The other one wasn't tugging at me. And just the longer earphones were just a lot more comfortable for me over the shorter ones. And the use of lightning to charge. So the lightning cable really makes it a lot more user-friendly, and I really do like how user-friendly the Beats X are. So some of the pros of the Power Beats are, it also has the W1 chip, which makes pairing a breeze. That means you can enjoy your music without having to worry about your sweat getting all over the earphones and damaging them while you're having a run or going to the gym. The ear hooks are a really great feature for people who are very active and constantly moving or doing high intensity workouts that require a lot of movement. Generally, earphones, they stay in for a while, but after some time they get nudged loose and you have to push them back in. These, I didn't have that problem with. They stayed in place the entire time. The last pro is completely by my own choice, and I believe that these are a lot more cooler. They look so much cooler when you wear them as compared to the Beats X, because the Beats X are kind of dorky looking. They're still wired and long, and you know, sometimes this gray color also really makes me feel like it's a little bit more geeky, but this black really blends in well, and it's short, and they look a lot more cooler when you're wearing them. Now I'm going to continue on to the cons of both the Beats X and the Power Beats, and I'm going to start off with the Beats X. The Beats X, I didn't have a lot of cons with it, but one of them is that it's not sweat resistant or water resistant. But I believe that they are sweat resistant to a pretty good extent, because I had the Beats X accidentally go into the laundry for about 10 minutes, and they were completely soaked when I pulled them out. And after putting them in rice for a couple of hours, when I took them out, they were working perfectly fine and they had no issues whatsoever. So I'm thinking maybe they are sweat resistant. So the design of the Power Beats are a bit nerdy, they're long, and they look a little bit weird in certain cases, but I think Beats was focusing on function here, not form, and they did a good job because this is function over form and this is form over function. And I prefer function in this case. And the cons of the Power Beats. The cons here are, I've discussed a lot of the gripes I've had with it and a lot of it is personal, but one of the key cons here is that it still uses micro USB to charge. They didn't upgrade to USB-C or Lightning. I would have been happy to see either because USB-C is a little bit outdated now. No new devices are coming out with USB-C and I feel like that they should have made the jump since they did redesign, they did refresh it. One of the biggest issues I faced with these were comfort. They are not as comfortable as the Beats X. And one of the key reasons behind that is the length of the cable. It's pretty short, and especially for someone with fatter and thicker necks like me, it becomes annoying, especially when you're doing activities that require to turn your head or look side to side, which happens a lot when you're going to the gym. So in conclusion here, what I feel is that even though the Power Beats 3 are priced extremely aggressively now at $130, I don't think they're worth the price, simple enough, because the design is in desperate need of an update. It's pretty old now. The comfort levels are nowhere as close to they are with the Beats X. They really need to improve the comfort on these, and despite, you know, paying $20 more for these, I would definitely pay $20 every time and buy these because they're comfortable, and comfort is something that I look for when I go for earphones. So this conclusion isn't based really on facts or numbers or, you know, technical data. It's really based on my own personal experience, and I would love to hear what you guys have to think about this. Have any of the owners of Power Beats loved it over the Beats X, or do you Beats X owners agree that they're better over the Power Beats? And just let me know what you think. And thank you so much for watching this video. I would love to hear your feedback and the views on my final conclusion. I will definitely be replying to all the comments in this video to make sure that the discussion keeps moving. And I'm excited to hear what you guys have to say about this. It would really help me, guys, if you could share this video with your friends and family, like the video, subscribe to the channel to see even more tech videos coming up. Thank you so much and have a great one, guys. We'll never grow. We'll be right back.